Unit 18, Non-Cooperation and Khilafat Movements, 1919-1919 to 1922-1922. Structure 18.0 Objectives 18.1 Introduction 18.2 Background 18.3 The issue of Khilafat 18.4 Towards Non-Cooperation Calcutta to Nagpur 18.5 Main phases of the Non-Cooperation Movement 18.6 People's response to the movement 18.7 Spread of the movement Local variations 18.8 The last phase 18.9 Causes of withdrawal 18.10 Impact 18.11 Let us sum up 18.12 Keywords 18.13 Answers to check your progress exercises 18.0 Objectives After reading this unit, you will be able to discuss the reasons for launching the non-cooperation and Khilafat movements, familiarize yourself with the program of action adopted in these movements, learn about the response of the Indian people towards these movements, learn about the impact of these movements. 18.1 Introduction During 1920, 1920 to 1921, 1921, the Indian National Movement entered into a new phase, that is, a phase of mass politics and mass mobilization. The British rule was opposed through two mass movements, Khilafat and non-cooperation. Though emerging out of separate issues, both these movements adopted a common program of action. The technique of non-violent struggle was adopted at a national level. In this unit, we discuss the reasons for launching of these movements, the course of the movements, role of leadership and the people. This unit also analyzes the regional variation and the impact of these movements. 18.2 Background The background to the movements was provided by the impact of the First World War, the Rowlatt Act, the Jallianwala Bagh massacre and the Montauk-Chelmsford reforms. First point During the post-First World War period, the prices of daily commodities increased sharply and the worst sufferers were the common people. The volume of imports, which declined during the First World War, again increased towards the end of the war. As a result, the Indian industries suffered, production fell, many factories were closed and the workers became its natural victims. The peasantry was also under the heavy burden of rents and taxes. So, the economic situation of the country in the post-war years became alarming. In the political field, the nationalists were disillusioned when the British did not keep their promise of bringing in a new era of democracy and self-determination for the people. This strengthened the anti-British attitude of the Indians. Point number 2 The next important landmark of this period was the passing of the Rowlatt Act in March 1919. This act empowered the government to imprison any person without trial and conviction in a court of law. Its basic aim was to imprison the nationalists without giving them the opportunity to defend themselves. Gandhi decided to oppose it through Satyagraha. March and April 1919, 1919, witnessed a remarkable political awakening in India. there were hartals, meaning strikes, and demonstration against the Rowlatt Act. Point number 3. The same period witnessed the naked brutality of the British imperialists at Jallianwala Bagh in Amritsar. An unarmed but large crowd had gathered on 13th April 1919 at Jallianwala Bagh to protest against the arrest of their popular leaders Dr. Saifuddin Kichlu, Saifuddin Kichlu, and Dr. Satyapal. General Dyer, the military commander of Amritsar, ordered his troops to open fire without warning on the unarmed crowd in a park from which there was no way out. Thousands were killed and wounded. This shocked the whole world. The famous poet Rabindranath Tagore renounced his knighthood in protest. Point number 4. The introduction of another constitutional reform act, which is known as the Government of India Act 1919-1919, further disillusioned the nationalists. The reform proposals failed to satisfy the rising demand of the Indians for self-government. The majority of the leaders condemned it as disappointing and unsatisfactory. All these developments prepared the ground for a popular upsurge against the British government. The Khilafat issue gave an added advantage to get the Muslim support, and the final touch to it was given by Gandhi's leadership. We will discuss now the Khilafat issue, which provided the immediate background to the movement. 18.3. The issue of Khilafat. During the First World War, Turkey allied with Germany and Austria against the British. The Indian Muslims regarded the Sultan of Turkey as their spiritual leader Khilafat, so naturally their sympathies were with Turkey. After the war, the British removed the Khalifa from power in Turkey. Hence, the Muslims started the Khilafat movement in India for the restoration of the Khalifa's position. Their main demand were Khalifa's control should be retained over the Muslim sacred places. In territorial adjustments after the war, the Khalifa should be left with sufficient territories. In early 1919-1919, a Khilafat committee was formed in Bombay. The initiative was taken by the Muslim merchants, and their actions were confined to meetings, petitions, and deputations in favor of Khalifa. However, there soon emerged a militant trend within the movement. The leaders of this trend were not satisfied with the moderate approach. Instead, they preached for the launching of a countrywide movement. They advocated for the first time at the All India Khilafat Conference in Delhi, 22-23 November 1919, non-cooperation with the British government in India. It was in this conference that Hazrat Mohani made a call for the boycott of British goods. The Khilafat leadership clearly spelled out that in case the peace terms after the war were unfavorable to Muslims, they would stop all cooperation with the government. In April 1920-1920, Shaukat Ali warned the British that in case the government failed to pacify Indian Muslims, we would start a joint Hindu-Muslim movement of non-cooperation. Shaukat Ali further stressed that the movement would start under the guidance of Mahatma Gandhi, a man who commands the respect of both Hindus and Muslims. The Khilafat issue was not directly linked with politics in India, but the Khilafat leaders were eager in enlisting the support of Hindus. Gandhi saw in this an opportunity to bring about Hindu-Muslim unity against the British. But in spite of his support to the Khilafat issue and being the president of the All India Khilafat Committee, Gandhi till May 1920 had adopted a moderate approach. However, the publication of the terms of the treaty with Turkey, which were very harsh towards Turkey, and the publication of the Hunter Committee report on Punjab disturbances in May 1920 infuriated the Indians, and the Gandhi now took an open position. The Central Khilafat Committee met at Allahabad from 1st to 3rd June 1920. The meeting was attended by a number of Congress and Khilafat leaders. In this meeting, a program of non-cooperation towards the government was declared. This was to include boycott of titles confirmed by the government, boycott of civil services, army and police, that is all government jobs, and non-payment of tax to the government. August 1st 1920 was fixed as the date to start the movement. Gandhi insisted that unless the Punjab and Khilafat wrongs were undone, there was to be non-cooperation with the government. However, for the success of this movement, Congress support was essential. Therefore, Gandhi's efforts now were to make the Congress adapt the non-cooperation program. Check your progress 1. Question number 1. Which of the following statements are correct or wrong? Mark tick for correct answers or cross for wrong answers. The Rowlatt Act was passed mainly to suppress the Indian nationalist. Second question. The Jallianwala Bagh massacre exposed the true character of the British imperialism. Third question. The Montague-Chelmsford reforms fulfilled the expectation of the Indian nationalist. Fourth question. Gandhi became the president of the All Indian Khilafat Committee. Second question. What was the Khilafat issue? Write in 5 lines. Towards non-cooperation. Calcutta to Nagpur. It was not an easy task for Gandhi to get the entire Congress to approve his program of political action. According to Professor Ravinder Kumar, Gandhi made a concerted bid to convince Tilak of the virtues of Satyagraha and of the expediency of an alliance with the Muslim community over Khilafat. However, Tilak was skeptical of Satyagraha as an instrument of politics. He was also not in favor of having an alliance with Muslim leaders over a religious issue. The basis of cooperation between Hindus and Muslims, argued Tilak, should be a secular one like the Lucknow Pact 1916. A lot dependent on Tilak's attitude, whether hostile or neutral, but unfortunately he passed away on 1st August 1920. Lala Lajpat Rai and C.R. Das opposed the Gandhian idea of boycotting council elections. Jawaharlal Nehru wrote in his autobiography that almost the entire old guard of the Congress opposed Gandhi's resolution of non-cooperation. The program of non-cooperation and boycott was then placed before the provincial congress committees for their opinions. The PCC of the United Provinces, after prolonged debate, approved of the principle of non-cooperation, gradual boycott of government schools and colleges, government offices, British goods. But there were reservations about the boycott of the legislative councils. The Bombay PCC approved of non-cooperation as the legitimate method of agitation, but it objected to boycott of council and only recommended boycott of British goods as a first stage. The Bengal PCC agreed to accept the principle of non-cooperation but disagreed with the idea of council boycott. The Madras PCC approved the policies of non-cooperation but rejected Gandhi's program. While this was the attitude of the traditional basis of Indian politics to Gandhi's program, the comparatively non-traditional areas in Indian politics like Gujarat and Bihar fully backed Gandhi's program. The Andhra and Punjab PCCs approved of non-cooperation but deferred a decision on Gandhi's program until the special Congress session. The dilemma of some of the provincial Congress leaders in supporting Gandhi's program was because of the future uncertainty of Gandhi's movement and their unwillingness to boycott the council elections. It was under these circumstances that a special session of the All Indian Congress Committee was held at Calcutta in September 1920. Lala Lajpat Rai was its president. A strong opposition to Gandhi's program was expected at this session, but contrary to the intentions of most established political leaders, before the session began, Gandhi managed to get his proposals accepted at the open session of the Congress by majority of 1000 vote. Among Gandhi's supporters were Motilal Nehru, Saifuddin Kichlu, Jitendral Banerjee, Shaukat Ali, Yaqub Hasan and Dr. Ansari. While his opponents included Pandit Madan, Mohan Malaviya, Annie Besant, etc. Gandhi's success came mainly because of the support from the business groups and the Muslims. The Calcutta Congress approved a program of surrender of titles, the boycott of schools, courts, foreign goods and councils, and encouragement of national schools, arbitration courts and Qadi. The Congress supported Gandhi's plan for non-cooperation with government till the Punjab and Khilafat wrongs were removed and Swaraj established. The final decision was left for the Nagpur session of the Congress to be held in December 1920, 1920. However, the precise nature of the Swaraj at which Gandhi aimed was not clear to contemporaries. Although Gandhi said that it was parliamentary Swaraj in accordance with the wishes of the people of India, Jawaharlal Nehru admitted that it was a vague Swaraj with no clear ideology behind it. In November 1920, following the reformed franchise, the council elections were held. All the Congress candidates boycotted the elections. Gandhi's call for boycotting elections got massive response from different India provinces. This was an alarming sign for the British government. Only 27.3% of the Hindus voters and 12.1% of the Muslims electorate participated in urban areas. In the rural areas, 41.8% of the Hindus and 28.3% of the Muslims voted. In the midst of lot of controversies and debates over the Gandhian program, the Congress session started at Nagpur from 26th December 1920. 1920. The Nagpur Congress saw the dramatic change of C.R. Das of Bengal from a critic of Gandhi's program to the mover of the non-cooperation resolution at Nagpur. It endorsed the non-cooperation resolution, which declared that the entire scheme, beginning with the renunciation of all voluntary association with the government at one end and refusal to pay taxes at the other, should be put into force at a time to be decided by the Congress. Resignation from the councils, renunciation of legal practice, nationalization of education, economic boycott, organization of workers for national service, raising of a national fund, and Hindu-Muslim unity were suggested as steps in the program. The Nagpur session also brought a revolutionary change in the Congress organization. The changes were formation of a working committee of 15 members, formation of an All India Committee of 350 members, 350. Formation of Congress committees from town to village level, reorganization of provincial Congress committees on a linguistic basis, and opening of Congress membership to all men and women of the age of 21 or more on payment of 4 annas as annual subscription. This was the first positive move on the part of the Congress to make it real mass-based political party. This period also witnessed a fundamental change in the social composition of the party as well as in its outlook and policies. Gandhi, with a novel weapon of Satyagraha, emerged as the mass leader in the Congress party. From the above discussion, it becomes clear that the program of the non-cooperation movement had two main aspects: constructive and destructive. Under the first category came the nationalization of education, the promotion of indigenous goods, the popularization of charkha and khadi, and the enrollment of a volunteer corps. In the later category figured the boycott of law courts, educational institution, election to the legislature, official functions, British goods, as well as the surrender of honours and titles conferred by the British. 18.5. Main phases of the non-cooperation movement. The campaign for non-cooperation and boycott started with great enthusiasm from early 1921. 1921. However, we find some changes in the central emphasis of the movement from one phase to other. In the first phase from January to March 1921, the main emphasis was on the boycott of schools, colleges, law courts, and the use of charkha. There was widespread student unrest, and top lawyers like C.R. Das and Motilal Nehru gave up their legal practice. This phase was followed by the second phase, started from April 1921. In this phase, the basic objectives were the collection of rupees 1 crore for the Tilak Swaraj Fund by August 1921. 1921. Enrolling 1 crore Congress members and installing 20 lakh charkhas by 30th June. In the third phase, starting from July, the stress was on boycott of foreign cloth, boycott of the forthcoming visit of the Prince of Wales in November 1921. 1921, popularization of Charkha and Khadi and Jailbaro by Congress volunteers. In the last phase between November 1921, a shift towards radicalism was visible. The Congress volunteers rallied the people and the country was on the verge of a revolt. Gandhi decided to launch a non-revenue campaign at Bardoli and also a mass civil disobedience movement for freedom of speech, press and association. But the attack on a local police station by angry persons at Chowri Chowra in Gorakhpur district of UP on 5th February 1922 changed the whole situation. Gandhi, shocked by this incident, withdrew the non-cooperation movement. 18.6 People's response to the movement. The leadership of this movement in the initial stage came from the middle class, but the middle class had a lot of reservation about Gandhi's program. In places like Calcutta, Bombay, Madras, which were centers of elite politicians, the response to Gandhi's movement was very limited. Their response to the call for resignation from government service, surrendering of titles, etc. was not very encouraging. However, the economic boycott received support from the Indian business group because the textile industry has benefited from the nationalist emphasis on the use of Swadeshi. Still, a section of the big business remained critical of the non-cooperation movement. They were particularly afraid of labor unrest in the factories following the non-cooperation movement. Besides the elite politicians, the comparative newcomers in Indian politics found expression of their interest and aspiration in the Gandhian movement. Leaders like Rajendra Prasad in Bihar, Sardar Vallabhai Patel in Gujarat provided solid support to Gandhian movement. In fact, they found non-cooperation as a visible political alternative to terrorism in order to fight against a colonial government. The response from the students and women was very effective. Thousands of students left government schools and colleges and joined national schools and colleges. The newly started national institution like the Kashi Vidyapeeth, the Gujarat Vidyapeeth and the Jamia Millia Islamia and others accommodated many students, although several others were disappointed. Students became active volunteers of the movement. Women also came forward. They gave up purdha and offered their jewelry for the Tilak fund. They joined the movement in large numbers and took active part in picketing before the shop selling foreign clothes and liquor. The most important landmark of this movement was the massive participation of the peasants and workers in it. The long-standing grievance of the toiling masses against the British as well as the Indian masters got an opportunity through this movement to express their real feelings. Although the Congress leadership was against class war, the masses broke their restraint. In rural areas and some other places, the peasants turned against the landlords and the traders. This gave a new dimension to the movement of 1921-1921 to 1922-1922.
UPSC Preparation, Unit 18, Non-Cooperation and Khilafat Movements, 1919-1919 to 1922-1922. Recording Part 1. Heading 18.7 Spread of the Movement, Local Variations. The call for non-cooperation and boycott no doubt got massive response from different parts of India. The years 1921 and 1922, 1921 and 1922 were marked by massive popular protests against the British Raj in India. However, the movement was shaped in most places according to local conditions. It was the local grievances of the people which found expression through this movement, and the instructions of the Congress leadership were not always followed. Let us take a brief look at different regions in relation to the non-cooperation movement. Next paragraph, Bengal. Mass participation in the Gandhian method of protest was less enthusiastic in Bengal. Rabindranath Tagore appreciated Gandhi for bringing to the masses a new consciousness, but he attacked his narrowness, obscurantism, obscurantism, and charkha, charkha. Elites of Calcutta were critical of some Gandhian ways, but the non-cooperation movement nevertheless brought about unique communal unity and an awakening in the urban and rural masses. Hartals, HARTALS, strikes and mass quoting of arrest greatly pressurized the British government to change its attitude towards India. In the countryside, an intense propaganda was carried on, and as a government report said, open inverted commas, the things that are said and done in Gandhi's name would make that gentleman shudder if ever he heard a fraction of them. Closed inverted commas. The villagers in Midnapur district opposed the newly created union boards and the tax imposed by them. The people refused to pay taxes or agricultural rent to the government or private landlords in the outlying districts of North Bengal. Next paragraph, Bihar. In Bihar, the local issue of the right to graze cattle on common government wastelands and the confrontation between the lower and upper castes on the issue of the former taking the sacred thread got merged with the non-cooperation movement. The issues of cow protection and the rights of kisans, K-I-S-A-N-S, were also focused upon. Because of this linkage, North Bihar, especially Champaran, Saran, Muzaffarpur and Purnia districts became the storm centers of the movement by November 1921. Hutt, which is a village market, looting and confrontation with the police became frequent. Next paragraph, UP. The United Provinces became a strong base of the Gandhian non-cooperation movement. Organized non-cooperation was an affair of cities and small towns. In the countryside, it took a different form. Here, the movement got entangled with the Kisan movement. Despite the repeated appeal for non-violence from the Congress leadership, the peasants rose in revolt not only against Talukdars, T-A-L-U-K-D-A-R-S, but also against merchants. Between January and March 1921, the districts of Rai Bareli, Pratapgarh, Faizabad, and Sultanpur witnessed widespread agrarian agrarian riots under the leadership of Baba Ramchandra. The major demands were, number one, no Nazrana, between brackets, extra premium on rent. Number two, no eviction from holdings. And number three, no Begar, in between brackets, forced labor, and Rasad, between brackets, forced supplies, etc. Next page. In late 1921, there was another strong peasant outburst, which is known as the Eka movement, EKA movement, under a radical leader, Madari Passi. The basic demand here was the conversion of produce rents into cash. Another significant event was the destruction of thousands of acres of reserved forests in the Kumaon division, Kumaon division, in July 1921, by the hill tribes, as they disliked the forest regulations. Next paragraph, Punjab. In Punjab, the response to this movement was not very remarkable in the city areas. But here, the powerful Akali movement for reform and control of the Gurudwaras got closely identified with non-cooperation. Although Gandhi gave it only guarded approval, his non-cooperation tactic was consistently used by the Akalis, AKALIS. It showed a remarkable communal unity between the Sikhs, the Muslims, and the Hindus. Next paragraph, Maharashtra. In Maharashtra, non-cooperation remained relatively weak because the Tilakites, Tilakites, were unenthusiastic about Gandhi, and non-Brahmins felt that the Congress was a Chitpavan, Chitpavan, led affair. The higher castes disliked Gandhi's emphasis on the elevation of the depressed classes and their participation in the non-cooperation movement. However, there were some sporadic local outbursts. At Malagaon, Malagaon, in Nasik district, a few policemen were burnt to death following the arrest of some local leaders. In the Pune area, some peasants tried to defend their land rights through Satyagraha, Satyagraha. Next paragraph, Assam. Non-cooperation received massive support in the distant province of Assam. In the gardens of Assam, the coolies rose in revolt with shouts of Gandhi Maharaj ki jai for higher wages and better condition of work. There were also signs of a non-revenue movement against peasants. Next paragraph, Rajasthan. Peasant movements in the princely states of Rajasthan strengthened the non-cooperation movement as they did in Bihar and UP. The peasants protested against cesses, C-E-S-S-E-S, and Begar, B-E-G-A-R. The Bijolia movement in Mewar and the Bhil movement under Motilal Tejawat acquired impetus, I-M-P-E-T-U-S, from the non-cooperation movement. Next paragraph, Andhra. In Andhra, the grievances of tribal and other peasants against forest laws got linked to the non-cooperation movement. A large number of these people met Gandhi in Kudappa, Cuddappa, in September 1921 to get their taxes reduced and forest restrictions removed. Forest officials were boycotted. To assert their right, they sent their cattle forcibly into the forests without paying the grazing tax. In the Paland area, P-A-L-A-N-D area of the periphery of forests, Swaraj was declared and police parties were attacked. Gandhi Raj, the protesters believed, was about to come. A powerful movement for non-payment of land revenue also developed in Andhra between December 1921 and February 1922. The non-cooperation movement attained great success in the Andhra Delta area. In the same period, Alluri Sitaram Raju organized the tribals in Andhra and combined their demands with those of the non-cooperation movement. Next paragraph, Karnataka. Karnataka areas remained comparatively unaffected by the movement and the initial response of the upper and middle class professional groups in several areas of the Madras Presidency was limited. Out of 682 title holders, only 6 returned their honours and 36 lawyers gave up their legal practice. In the entire presidency, 92 national schools with 5,000 pupils were started. The labour in the Buckingham and Carnatic textile mills went on strike from July to October 1921. They were given moral support by the local non-cooperation leaders. Similar responses were there in many other regions. For example, in Orissa, the tenants of the Kanika Raj refused to pay abwabs, A-B-W-A-B-S. But in Gujarat, the movement went on purely Gandhian lines. Next paragraph, check your progress. 2. Question number 1. What was the program of the non-cooperation movement? Write in 50 words. Number 2. Discuss in brief the response of the peasantry to the non-cooperation movement. Question number 3. Which of the following statements are correct or wrong? Number 1. The Nagpur session of the AICC brought some revolutionary changes in the Congress organization. Number 2. Gandhi's program got no response from rural areas. Number 3. The non-cooperation movement was shaped in most places according to local conditions. UPSC preparation, Unit 18, Non-Cooperation and Khilafat Movements, 1919-1922. Recording Part 2, Heading 18.8, The Last Phase. The government very carefully observed the developments and collected secret reports from the provinces about the progress of the movement. When the movement ultimately started, the government took recourse to repression. The Congress and the Khilafat volunteer organizations were declared unlawful. Public assemblies and processions were banned. At many places, the police fired on the Satyagrahis. Satyagrahis. Arrests and lathi charge became a common scene. By the end of 1921, all important leaders except Gandhi were imprisoned. Alarmed by Hindu-Muslim unity, the government also tried to create a split between the Congress and the Khilafatists. Khilafatists. Thus, the government machinery was fully geared to crush the movement. Next page. The repression by the British strengthened the determination of the Indians to continue the movement with greater vigor. Meanwhile, the Viceroy tried to negotiate with the Congress leaders through Madan Mohan Malviya and offered to recognize the national volunteers and to release the political prisoners. In mid-January 1922, Gandhi explained the position of the non-cooperation movement at the All Parties Conference, and there was general agreement on his assessments. On 1st February, he sent an ultimatum to the Viceroy that he could start mass civil disobedience if the political prisoners were not released and repressive measures not abandoned. Since the whole country was not fit for civil disobedience, he decided to launch it on 5th February. Congress volunteers were fired at by the police at Chauri Chaura, Chauri, in Gorakhpur district in UP. In retaliation, the infuriated mob killed 21 policemen. This violent incident shocked Gandhi and he suspended the non-cooperation movement. He also postponed the proposed civil disobedience at Bardoli, Bardoli. Many congressmen were shocked and surprised by Gandhi's decision. They vehemently protested against it. Subhash Chandra Bose called it a national calamity. Jawaharlal Nehru expressed his amazement and consternation, consternation, at the decision. Explaining his position, Gandhi replied to Jawaharlal Nehru, "The movement had unconsciously drifted from the right path. We have come back to our moorings, MOORINGS, and we can again go straight ahead." Next paragraph. On 12th February 1922, the Congress Working Committee meeting at Bardoli condemned the inhuman conduct of the mob at Chauri Chaura. It endorsed the suspension of the mass civil disobedience movement. The same day, Gandhi started his 5-day fast as penance, PENANCE. Thus, the first non-cooperation virtually came to an end. Gandhi was arrested on 10th March 1922 and was sentenced to 6 years imprisonment. Next paragraph. The Khilafat issues also lost its relevance when Kemal Pasha, Kemal Pasha, came to power in Turkey. The Sultan of Turkey was stripped of all political power. Kemal Pasha wanted to modernize Turkey and to make it a secular state. The Caliphate, Caliphate, was abolished. Naturally, it led to an end of Khilafat movement. Next heading, 18.9, causes of withdrawal. Explaining the causes of withdrawal of the non-cooperation movement, Gandhi said that the Chauri Chaura incident had forced him to withdraw the movement. The incident proved that the country still had not learnt the lesson from the non-violence. To quote Gandhi, "I would suffer every humiliation, every torture, absolute ostracism, ostracism, and death itself to prevent the movement from becoming violent." Next paragraph. As far as the peasants were concerned, the non-cooperation movement was gradually turning into a no-rent movement against the Zamindars, Zamindars. But the Congress leadership was in no way interested in attacking the legal rights of the Zamindars. Gandhi's aim was of a controlled mass movement involving different Indian classes and not a class revolution. So, he was against the continuation of this movement, which might turn into a class revolution. He made it quite clear that he was against any kind of violent or radical movement at that stage. In spite of an objective revolutionary situation existing in India, there was no alternative revolutionary leadership. If the movement was not suspended, it might have led to chaos because the leadership had no control over local movements. Next page, heading 18.10, impact. In spite of its failure, the non-cooperation movement has great significance in Indian history, not only in relation to political spheres, but in terms of social aspects also. Gandhi emphasized the need of removing evils like caste barriers, communalism, untouchability, etc. In the processions, meetings, and in jails, people of all castes and communities worked together and even ate together. This weakened the caste separateness and accelerated the pace of social mobility and reform. The lower classes could raise their head high without fear. This movement showed remarkable unity between the Hindus and the Muslims. At many places, it was difficult to distinguish between non-cooperation, Khilafat, and Kisan Sabha meeting. Next paragraph. The economic boycott in 1920-22 was more effective than the Swadeshi movement in 1905-1908 after the partition of Bengal. As against 1,292 million yards of British cotton price goods imported in 1905-1908, only 955 million yards could be imported in 1921 to 1922. This naturally created panic among the British capitalists. The Indian textile industry had immensely benefited by the boycott of foreign goods. Indian mill owners' influence increased considerably. On the other hand, recurrent labor strikes in 1921-1921 created panic among these mill owners. The popularization of Charkha and Kadgha, the village reconstruction program, through self-help and through panchayats, brought about economic revival and handloom cloth production went up. Next paragraph. In the political field, the non-cooperation and Khilafat movements involving all the communities and all classes added a new dimension to the national movement. The national movement had been strengthened in more than one way. A new nationalist awareness was generated, and the national movement reached the remotest corners of the land. The common people, for the first time, became an integral part of the mainstream of the national movement. Self-confidence and self-esteem among the Indian people developed tremendously. It brought a real feeling of freedom in place of frustration and helplessness. It boosted the morale of the people and raised national dignity. Next paragraph, check your progress 3. Question number 1. Discuss the impact of non-cooperation movement in Indian history. Write in about 100 words. Question number 2. Why was the movement suspended? Answer in 5 lines. Question number 3. Mark the statements correct or wrong. Number 1. The British government tried to create a split between the Congress. And the Khilafatists. Number 2. The Chauri Chaura incident had no effect on Gandhiji. Number 3. The Khilafat movement was withdrawn at the call of Congress. Number 4. The non-cooperation movement for the first time brought the masses in the mainstream of Indian politics. UPSC preparation. Unit 18, Non-Cooperation and Khilafat Movements, 1919-1919-1922. Recording Part 3, Heading 18.11, Let Us Sum Up. The Non-Cooperation Movement was undoubtedly a landmark in the history of Indian struggle for independence. The introduction of the Rowlatt, R-O-W-L-A-T-T Act, the Montagu-Kelmsford MONTAGU-CHELMSFORD reforms, the Jallianwala Bagh massacre and the Khilafat issue provided the background of non-cooperation movement. Gandhi wanted to use the Khilafat issue for a united Hindu-Muslim movement against the British government. In spite of initial objections by some Congress leaders to the merger of the Khilafat issue with the nationalist movement, Gandhi finally persuaded them to launch a non-cooperation movement against the British Raj. The program of the movement involved boycott of government and educational institutions, law courts, legislatures, use of charkha and khadi, etc. The movement got massive support from different parts of India. The most remarkable feature was the participation of the common people in large scale for the first time in the national movement. The movement, however, gradually went out of control of the Congress leadership, particularly in the rural areas by the end of 1921. Finally, the Chowri Chowra incident shocked Gandhiji and he withdrew the movement. True, the movement failed to achieve its main objectives. The restitution of the caliphate, CALIPHATE, and the attainment of Swaraj. But the struggle between what Gandhi called the soul force and the material force brought a new awakening to the masses for their political rights. Gandhi rightly said that this movement had achieved in 1 year what could not be done in 30 years by earlier methods. In spite of the reservations made about the non-cooperation movement, we have to admit that these 2 years constituted a stormy period of Indian nationalism when about the whole of India for the first time stood up against the mighty British Raj. Next heading, 18.12, keywords. AICC, that is All India Congress Committee. Charkha, that is spinning wheel. Kargha, KARGHA, that is hand loom. Khadi, that is hand spun cloth. Khalifa, that is successor to the prophet. Non-cooperation, that is policy of non-cooperating with the British manifested through boycott of educational institutions, courts, councils, etc. Panchayat, that is traditional Indian court of arbitration. PCC, that is Provincial Congress Committee. Satyagraha, Gandhian method of movement based on the philosophy of truth and non-violence. Swadeshi, that is indigenous. Swaraj, that is self-rule.